Hello, everyone. Now I will explain the third experiment to you, the Layer 2 WLAN Sidehanging Network Experiment. This is a relatively simple networking method. Let's take a look. Why this experiment is called Layer 2 networking is because our network traffic goes directly through the switch to the upstream network without passing through the AC. So this configuration is suitable for small and medium-sized WLAN deployments. First, let's take a look at our network diagram. At the top is a router, in the middle is a core switch. Below that are access switches, and beside hangs an AC. At the bottom are two APs. Now, let's take a look at our experiment planning. One port on the core switch is an access port. Ports 2 and 3 are trunk ports. The access port will use VLAN 30, port 2 passes VLAN 10, port 3 passes VLAN 20. On the second switch, the first three ports, the first two ports default to VLAN 10, and then we trunk VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. The third port defaults to VLAN 1, and then we trunk VLAN 10 and 20. On the AC, we have only VLAN 10, so here is the planning of its IP addresses. In this scenario, our DHCP server for user address allocation is served by the core switch. Then, the address allocation for the APs is managed by the AC as a DHCP server. Here are their address pools. We also need a source interface address for the AC, 10.1.1.1. Later, we will also need to configure the AP group, domain management template, SSID template, security template, and VAP template. Now let's take a look at the configuration. First, we need to configure on SW1, enable VLANs 10, 20, and 30 in bulk. Of course, beforehand, you can also change the names. Then, according to our plan above, for different interfaces, we configure different port modes, both access and trunk. This is the configuration on the core switch. Next, let's configure our access switch. First, also change the name on the access switch. Then, generate VLANs in bulk. Similarly, according to our planning chart, for different interfaces, we need to configure different VLANs and different modes. This covers the configurations on both switches. Next, let's look at the configuration on the AC. On the AC, we only need to configure VLAN 10. Let's look at the AC. After entering the AC, I previously named it AC2. First, we can check the usage of the corresponding ports on the AC. You can use the command display LLBP neighbor brief to check. Now we can see port 2 of SW1 is connected to this AC on GE001. Next, the configuration needs to be set up on GE001. As per our experiment guide, we have it listed as 002. That's not a problem, just configure according to the actual port used. That will suffice. Next, let's configure. First, we enter the system view. Then, enter interface 001. Now, we can display this to check under this port if there are any data. Of course, before that, we first need to create VLAN 10. VLAN 10. If creating a single VLAN, this command is sufficient. Then enter the port. If we want to keep it simple, we can directly use G001. This also allows entry into the first port. First, set the port property to trunk. Next, allow VLAN 10 to pass through. Then we can see that VLAN 10 is now set up. With that, the VLAN pass-through configuration is complete. Lastly, we need to save. Then, according to the experiment guide, we continue. Next, we need to configure the IP address and routing information to ensure our network is interconnected. First, configure on SW1. Firstly, configure the WLAN interface 20, also under the system view. This IP address can be set to 10.1.2.0.1/24. Just type /24 after the space. Let's check if the configuration is successful. Next, configure the interface VLAN if 30. Set address 10.1.30.2 with a 24-bit mask. This configuration is also completed. Next, let's configure the VLAN interface address on the AC. Also, don't forget to save. You should remember we were configuring AC2. Let's go back to AC2 and enter our VLAIF10 port. There's no data now. Then add the IP address 10.1.10.1 with a 24-bit mask. Configuration successful. Then save. Next, we need to enter our router, which is this device. On this device's corresponding port, we need to configure the IP address. Similarly, enter the system view and then check how our interface is connected. Use display LDP neighbor brief to see we use interface GE001 connected to switch 1SW1's GE001 port. Now we enter this interface and then configure the IP address. Now on router 1, we can go ahead and configure the IP address on interface GE001. Let's set the IP address. This is a shorthand. Then configure the IP 10.1.3.0.1 with a 24-bit mask. Now we can check that the address has been configured successfully. Next step, we need to configure a route because on R1, we need a route pointing to our switch to ensure our data packets are forwarded to our switch smoothly. So we need to configure a static route. Let's see how to configure a static route. IP router static is the keyword for static routing. Then our destination address is 10.1.2.0.0. meaning traffic to the 10.1.2.0.0 subnet will have this subnet as the destination. Its next hop is 10.1.3.0.2, which is on our switch 1. With this, we have now completed the interconnection from our switch 1 to our router. We can test on the router using a ping test to switch 1. We can ping with the -A option. What does -A mean? Specifies the source address, meaning in this command, we use the source address of 10.1.2.0.1 as the source address to pair with 10.1.3.0.1. So we can see the network is now connected. Our basic link is now established. Next, let's continue looking down. The next step, we need to configure the AP to come online. If our AP wants to come online, it needs to configure a DHCP server. Thus, the AP can obtain an IP address. Of course, our users also need a DHCP server, so users can get an IP address to access the internet. While the AP gets a management address, as we mentioned before, the DHCP server for our users is set up on switch 1, that is, on SW1. And the DHCP server used by the AP is configured on the AC. First, we configure on SW1 the DHCP server for user use. Enter the system view, then enable DHCP, enable now. Our router has enabled DHCP service. Then we enter this VLAN interface, VLAN interface, VLANIF20. This is the gateway for users. So in this VLAN interface, we enable DHCP service, DHCP select interface. Thus, our DHCP service can use the VLANIF20 interface to provide. Then step back and save. Next, we move to the AC to continue configuring for the AP as the management. IPs DHCP service first, enable DHCP service, then enter interface, VLANIF10. Set 10 as the DHCP selection port. Let's check the configuration. Now configuration is successful. Exit. Exit again. then save.